I'm Sharon Saltz, and I'm the editor of NeuroCentral. I'm here at AIC 18 to give you a brief overview of day one at the conference. So the day started with two symposium sessions, with the first being about innovative approaches in epidemiology. This session included a talk by Robert Stewart, who I actually got the chance to speak to in order to hear more about his talk on epidemiology in the era of big data. This will be published on NeuroCentral, so do keep your eyes peeled for that. And the second symposium included genetic and biological validation of Alzheimer's, GWAS genes, and their contributions to disease. After this, there was a focused topic session on dementia care practice recommendations for long-term care and community-based providers. This was then followed by several oral sessions covering various topics such as the development of new models to study dementia and neuroimaging. The exhibition hall was then open, where I was able to chat and meet so many lovely people at the NeuroCentral booth. If you haven't already popped by the booth today, then do make sure you pop by tomorrow or later in the week to find out more about our digital publishing opportunities. In addition to this, you can also spin our Wheel of Fortune to win a prize, and this includes any British sweets that we have available or a NeuroCentral tote bag. After lunch, I was able to attend the Emerging Concepts session on circadian rhythm dysfunction and general anesthesia in cognition and Alzheimer's disease. In particular, we heard more from Eric Musiek from Washington University on the bidirectional relationship between circadian rhythms and Alzheimer's disease pathology. He describes how aging, nighttime light and exposure, and neurodegenerative disease pathology may all directly affect our clocks. He described how one possible mechanism linking circadian function to Alzheimer's disease includes circadian proteins playing a role in glial cells to promote neuroinflammation. Another interesting point to mention from the event was how this year we have the highest percentage of women attending AIC today, with a report of 52%. So these were all of our highlights of the conference today, and you can find out more up-to-date coverage by following us on Twitter. Overall, it's been a fantastic day, and I can't wait to hear more about Alzheimer's disease research tomorrow taking place.